In this video, we're looking at painting the flesh tones of your Disciples of Tzeentch miniatures. We're going to look at painting the skin on pink, blue and brimstone horrors, and also Zangor and Karak Acolytes too. For each method, we're going to show you how to take it from battle ready up to parade ready standard, so you can decide which level you want to paint your miniatures at. Now, to prepare our models for painting, we've already undercoated them here. We've actually undercoated the Horrors and the Zangor with Grey Seer Spray and the Karak Acolyte with Wraithbone Spray. The first model we're going to be looking at is the Pink Horror, and for this we've undercoated it Grey Seer, and we're going to start with a contrast paint all over the flesh, which is Volupus Pink. For this we're using our medium shade brush, so let's get straight to it. Let's take a little bit of paint from the pot here and add it to our palette. Now, we're not going to be watering this down or thinning it at all, just making sure it's not overloaded on the brush. There we go. Perfect. Then onto the miniature. We're going to apply a nice, thick, even coat of Volupus Pink all over the Pink Horror, like so. Now, when you're applying contrast paint like this, don't be afraid to be messy on the first coat of paint all over the flesh. You can always go back later on and tidy up areas you hit accidentally. But do make sure you're going back and making sure it's not pooling in the recesses. You can see here on the leg, for example, the contrast paint started to pull together and gather in that recess. I'm just going to use our brush to poke it around and move it around. So you want a nice, even coat all over the miniature. Allow about 20 to 30 minutes for it to fully dry, and once that's done, we'll move on to the next stage. So there we go, the Volupus Pink has dried, giving this really cool effect on the miniature. Now, you could leave it there if you'd like to, and your flesh would be battle ready, but we're going to show you a few tips and tricks to take it up to parade ready standard. First of all, we're going to be using a cheeky wash of Druchy Violet, which we're going to thin down quite a lot all over the flesh. The reason we're doing this is to give a couple of nice little hints of purple in the recesses of the flesh. For this, we're using our medium shade brush. Let's take a little bit of paint from the pot like so and put it onto our palette like this. I'm just going to take a bit of water from our pot, thin it down just a touch. There we go. We want it to be nice and subtle, maybe three. There we go, absolutely perfect. So then onto the miniature, we're going to apply it very carefully all over the flesh. Now make sure you're concentrating in the recesses here. This will be very subtle, but that's exactly what we're trying to do. It's going to take a little while to dry as well. Leave about 10 to 15 minutes for it to fully dry. Once it has, we'll move on to the next stage. So there we go, the wash is dry, giving the skin a purple tint. Okay, up next it's time to add some highlights in, and as the skin is such a large part of this miniature, we'll be dry brushing them on to make it nice and easy. We'll start off with a dry brush naturally of Pink Horror, then we'll use Full Grim Pink after that. For both of these, we're using our large flat dry brush, so let's get straight to it. So let's take a little bit of paint from the Pink Horror pot here, and just brush it off most of it onto our piece of tissue paper here, like so. Dry brushing is called that way because we're taking most of the paint off the brush, and we want to have a nice dusty effect on the miniature. So here we go, onto the miniature. I'm going to be dry brushing it very carefully all over the skin, just like so. Try and use round or circular motions if possibly can to pick out the most details on the miniature. You'll see doing this means that the higher parts of the miniature are picked out and the lower recesses, which we've used Volupus Pink and Druchy Violet on, are left that colour. You can be as light or as heavy as you like on this dry brush, it's completely up to you. I'm going sort of a medium heaviness here, just picking out some of the muscles and structure of the flesh. Once this is done, time to move on to the next stage. Next up, we're doing the same again, this time a little bit lighter, but we're using Full Grim Pink here. A nice light dry brush around the miniature, just picking out some of the larger areas of detail. There we go, we've done the dry brush, we've also been around the rest of the model and tidy up the other areas ready for painting. Okay, it's time to split and move on to the Blue Horror. Here again, we started with a Grey Seer undercoat, and the first paint we're going to use is again a contrast paint, this time Talisar Blue. Again, for this, we're using our medium shade brush. So let's take a little bit of paint out of the pot here, again onto our palette like this. Again, we're not going to be thinning this down, just making sure we're not overloading the brush with too much paint. We want quite a bit though. There we go, perfect. Then, onto our Blue Horror. A nice, even coat of Talisar Blue all over the miniature's skin. Again, don't worry too much if you hit any other part of the miniature. We're always going to be able to go back and tidy that up later on. There we go, the Talisar Blue has dried and it's looking cool. Alright, again, you could leave that model there if you'd like to, and the flesh would be battle ready, but we're going to show you another couple of tips here just to take a little bit further up to parade ready level. First of all, we're going to add a wash of Dragonhof Nightshade, which we're going to thin down and place all over the miniature. We're doing this to slightly tone down that bright blue and to make it look a little bit more muted. For this, again, we're using our medium shade brush. I'm taking a little bit of paint out of the pot here and onto our palette. Here, we're just going to take a little bit of water and just thin it down here. Nice thin coat paint here. There we go, that is perfect. Then, onto the Blue Horror. We're going to pick it up and place it all over the miniature here. Again, this is just going to be helping mute down this really, really bright blue, make it look a bit more natural. There we go, the Dragonhof Nightshade has dried and our skin has a nice muted tone to it now. Alright, up next it's time to add a couple of highlights to our skin, and seeing as the skin is the large part of the miniature, we're going to be dry brushing this on. First of all, we're going to add a dry brush of Techless Blue, and after that we'll be using aptly Blue Horror. For both of these, we're using our medium dry brush. Here we go, let's take a little bit of paint from the pot here, and just add it onto our piece of tissue paper. Just going to make sure we're wiping most of the paint off onto the tissue here. There we go, and that's perfect. Then, onto the miniature, turn to very carefully, dry brush it across the miniature. So here we're going to be using circular motions around the model. There's a nice subtle highlight this, but it's going to add a nice solid colour to the raised parts of the miniature, like the muscles. Very carefully highlight the entire model like this with a dry brush. Once that's done, we'll move on to the next stage. Up next, we're adding another dry brush, this time of Blue Horror. Again, nice and light on the miniature, and just use circular motions here to make sure only the raised parts of the muscles are being picked out. Okay, there we go, that's the Blue Horror skin painted. Alright, it's time to heat things up as we're painting the Brimstone Horrors next. For this, we started with an undercoat of Grey Sear Spray. Once that's dry, we're going to be painting contrast paint Iandon Yellow all over. Let's grab our medium shade brush and let's get straight to it. So here we go, let's take a bit of paint from the pot here. Again, we're not thinning this down, we're just making sure it's not overloaded on the brush. There we go, just like that. Then, onto the Brimstone Horror, it's time to paint Iandon Yellow literally over the entire model. Now, as it's going on here, make sure it's not pooling together too much in any of the recesses. We don't want to have any sort of pooling going on. Just move the paint around with your brush as it's being applied. Once you've covered both Brimstone Horrors with Iandon Yellow, we'll move on to the next stage. And the Iandon Yellow has dried and our Brimstone Horrors are looking pretty hot. You can, of course, leave them there if you'd like to, and they would be battle ready. But we're going to add a few more layers of paint here to make them look like they're really on fire. We're actually going to use contrast paints to do this, unusually, and here's how we're going to do it. We'll add layers of Griffhound Orange, Blood Angels Red, Flesh Terrors Red, and finally Black Templar, all thinned down with contrast medium to add a really cool flamey effect to our Brimstone Horrors. First of all, it's time for that Griffhound Orange. Here we're using our medium shade brush again. Let's take a little bit of paint out of the pot here and add it to our palette like so. Then we're going to wash our brush off, make sure it's really, really heavily washed off. Make sure there's no paint left on that. Perfect. Then our contrast medium. We're adding a little bit to the palette here, maybe about one brushful per brushful of Griffhound Orange. A nice thin down paint there. Then onto the Brimstone Horror. We're going to be adding it here to the miniature, but we're working it up from the top. So we're leaving the bottom, the yellow colour, but we're working the top with the orange colour. And the reason we're doing this is, of course, because fire is hottest at the bottom, and that's where we want the yellow colour to be. So make sure you're adding the Griffhound Orange to the top here, make sure you're leaving the bottom of our Brimstone Horrors yellow. Up next is Blood Angels Red, and again we've thinned this down with contrast medium, and again we're just adding it to the very tops of the model here, not going quite down as far as we did with the Griffhound Orange, but just to the very tops of the flames here. Up next is Flesh Terrors Red, and again we've thinned this with contrast medium, and we're just adding it to the very, very tops of the flames like so. Make sure you're leaving some of the Blood Angels Red showing underneath so we get a nice gradient between the colours. And last but not least is Black Templar, again thinned down with contrast medium. Just apply to the very tips of some of the flames here to make it really look like it's burning. And there we go, that's the flesh painted on our Brimstone Horrors. Alright, up next it's time for the Zangor, and for this we start with an undercoat of Grey Sear Spray. Once that's dry, it's time to apply a wash over the flesh of Nighthaunt Gloom mixed with Larmian Medium. After that we're going to be applying a layer of Blue Horror, and then a highlight with Ulthuan Grey. First of all, it's time for that wash of Nighthaunt Gloom. For this we're using our medium shade brush. So first of all, let's take some Nighthaunt Gloom out of the pot like so, and onto our palette here. Then we're going to wash our brush off to make sure we're not going to contaminate the medium with any paint. Bit of tissue. There we go, perfect. So, Larmian Medium next. And we're using Larmian Medium here rather than water, so it stretches the paint out rather than thins it down. It'll also help it dry nice and slowly into the recesses of the miniature, giving a really nice subtle look to the wash. And that's exactly what we're after. So there we go, it's a perfect mix. Then, onto the Zangor. Just going to apply it very carefully all over the skin. Now it's going to be really thin on the raised areas and a really subtle appearance in the recesses. That's exactly what we're going for, to give a nice light look to our Zangor's flesh. It's also going to take a little while to dry, but don't worry about that. Leave about half an hour for it to fully dry, and once it has, we'll move on to that layer and highlight. So there we go, that's the Nighthaunt Gloom dry, and it's looking pretty cool. You could leave it there if you'd like, but we're going to add another layer here of Blue Horror to bring it up to parade-ready standard. So Blue Horror here just being applied very carefully to the raised areas, leaving the recesses the original colour we've just painted in. We're using a small layer brush here to be nice and careful to make sure we're not going into too many of the recesses. Take your time on this one. A nice solid layer over the top of the grey sea you've already painted, and it'll look really nice. And last but not least, we're adding a highlight of Ulthuan Grey. Here we've thinned it down quite a lot to make it quite subtle when it goes on, which is adding it to the very, very raised areas of our Zangor's flesh. So just around the muscles like this, very carefully, like so. Now we want this to be nice and thin highlights, so for this we're using our small layer brush. Just take your time, highlight the entire flesh, and it's going to look really nice. There we go, that's the highlight done. There's just one thing left we're going to do on the flesh, and that's to add a glaze of Drichy Violet, which we're going to thin down with Lamian Medium. We're going to add this to the bottom of the legs to give it that sort of nice transition on the bottom of the legs. We're also going to drop it into a few of the deepest recesses to give a purple tint to the skin. For this, we're using our small layer brush, which will have lots of control. Let's take a little bit of Drichy Violet from the pot here and add it to our palette like so. Then we're going to wash the brush off just to make sure we're not contaminating the medium again. There we go. And then we're going to add a couple of drops of Lamian Medium here. We're making a glaze here, which is why we're using Lamian Medium. We want the paint to stretch out rather than dry sort of blotches, which is what would happen if you used water on a paint this thin. There we go. Perfect. Then onto the Zangor. We're going to just apply it very carefully to the bottom of the legs like so to give a sort of hint of purple colour here, sort of a nice transition of colour. Now we're also going to drop it into some of the deepest recesses on the model, such as the chest here. We're going to drop it into the centre here and around the top of the chest muscles here. Anywhere else we want a slight hint of purple colour to make it look really magical and weird. There we go, the Drichy Violet glaze has dried on our Zangor and the skin is complete. Alright, up next let's have a look at the Karak Acolytes. Here we're going to be starting off with an undercoat of Wraithbone Spray. After that we're going to be applying a contrast paint, Gilliman Flesh, all over the flesh. For this we're using our medium shade brush. So, let's take a little bit of paint from the pot here and add it to our palette like so. We're not thinning the paint down here, we're just making sure we're not overloading the brush with too much paint. There we go. Perfect. Then, onto the Karak Acolytes, we're going to very carefully paint this contrast paint all over the flesh areas. Now, of course, normally you wanted to be doing the flesh first here, so it doesn't matter if you make a mistake and go on to other areas, but try and be as neat as you possibly can. Also with a contrast paint like this, as you're applying it, you'll notice it'll start pooling together or gathering in certain recesses. Like up here you can see, for example. I'm just going to poke that with a brush, just move it around to make sure it's not pooling in the recesses at all. A nice even coat all over the flesh. Once this is dry, we'll move on to the next stage. Okay, so the Gilliman flesh has dried on our Karak Acolyte skin, giving this really cool effect. Now, of course, you could leave it there if you'd like to, and that flesh would be battle ready, but we're going to show you how to take it a little bit further to make it parade ready. First of all, we're going to be adding a layer of Kislev flesh, we're going to slightly thin down to add over the top. Then we'll add highlights of both Flayed One flesh and Wraithbone over the top of that. For this, we're using our small layer brush just to make sure we've got lots of control. So let's take a little bit of Kislev flesh out of the pot, first of all, and add it to our palette here. Just a touch of water here to thin it down to make sure it goes onto the model nice and smoothly. Perfect. Then, onto our Karak Acolytes, we're going to very carefully pick out the raised parts of the flesh here. So you can see we're going to leave in the recesses the colour we've already applied. So that Gilliman flesh is showing through in the deeper parts of the miniature. I'm just painting the muscle tones here with Kislev flesh, like so. Be as careful as you can not to go into the recesses with this colour. It's going to be quite a subtle colour change, but it's important to put down a nice solid colour like this for the highlights we're going to be applying later on. Once we've gone around the entire model and layered up on top of the muscles, we'll move on to the next stage. Alright, up next we're going to be adding some highlights here. We've watered down some Flayed One flesh, thinned it down nicely, and we're going to add it to the edges of the muscles like so. Very carefully picking out the edges of the muscles like this all around. Again, we're using a small layer brush here for added control. Just picking out the raised areas of the musculature like this. It's important to use thin down Flayed One flesh here because we want a nice subtle mix, a nice subtle blend between the colours here. If you use just straight out of the pot, it'll be a bit harsh and won't look quite as good. And last but not least, we're adding a highlight here of Wraithbone. Here we've watered it down quite a lot to make sure it's quite thin, and it's going to go on very subtly on the edges inside the highlights we've already applied, like so. Just be really careful with this, just make sure it's not overloading the models. Really subtle highlight on the very edges of the muscles, like so. And do that around the flesh. Once that's done, the flesh will be done. And there we go, with the final highlight done, the flesh on our Karak Acolyte is complete. And that is 5 different ways to paint the flesh tones of your Disciples of Tzeentch models up to parade-ready standard. Hope you've enjoyed the video. Happy painting!